True Friendship. This story is of naughty Gattu and his sister Chinky. Once, Gattu and Chinky were playing in the garden of their house. And while playing, they heard barking of a dog. At first, they both ignored it. But when the dog kept on barking, Chinky went to the gate to find out what is the matter.
Why are you barking? What's the matter?
It seems he won't stop like this. I shall teach him a lesson.
Wait, Gattu. Hitting a poor animal like this is not the right thing to do. Come on, we will take him inside.
With affection, Chinky took him inside the house, cleaned his wound, did his dressing, gave him water, and loved him much.
Now you will get cured soon. And from today, you will live with us. But, my dear dog, what will we call you? Moti. Moti is a good name. Yes, from today, everyone will call you Moti.
He can't live with us. See how dirty he is.
Gattu.
Naughty Gattu didn't like this at all. After all, how could someone love a dirty animal like this? This thought was going on in his mind.
No matter what happens, I will get rid of this dirty animal.
By seeing affection between Chinky and Moti, Gattu became very jealous. He was unable to bear Moti's presence in the house. To get rid of Moti, Gattu started playing dirty tricks.
Now I will teach you a wonderful lesson, kid.
Chinky used to come and rescue Moti whenever Gattu tried to play dirty tricks with him.
Come on, Moti. It's evening now. You should take rest too.
Gattu thought of a trick after seeing Moti being tied outside the house.
Today I will leave you at such a place from where you will never be able to come back.
Moti? Gattu, have you seen Moti anywhere? I can't find him anywhere.
No, I haven't. I was sleeping.
Chinky was crying incessantly. Gattu was feeling very bad for Chinky, but he was happy that Moti had finally gone.
Don't cry, Chinky. Maybe Moti himself must have gone somewhere.
But he was my best friend.
And that night, a thief entered their house.
Help! Please, someone help! Please save me!
Hey, what kind of noise is this?
Seems someone is calling for help outside.
Gattu! Gattu! Wake up! I heard Moti barking right now.
Sleep! Moti will not come. Okay, come. Let's have a look.
Save me! From this dog! Please save me!
Spare him, Moti! But he has never done such thing to anyone. Who are you?
And then, Gattu saw his bicycle, which was lying there on the ground.
I understood everything. He's a thief who come to steal my bicycle. Tell me, am I right or not? Aren't you a thief?
Listen, now before I let Moti attack you again, get out from here.
Please forgive me, Chinky.
Why are you apologizing?
Because I didn't like his presence in our house. That's why I left Moti in a forest far away from our house. But how did he come back?
This is their special quality. Whomsoever they become friend to, they never leave them ever. When you left Moti in jungle, he came here by himself. And when he saw thief coming inside the house, then he attacked badly.
Right, Chinky. We all should learn a lesson from these innocent animals. That what is true friendship.
And this way, Gattu realized his mistake. And from that day onwards, Gattu and Moti became true friends.
Gattu has learned his lesson. Now it's your turn.
Eat healthy, stay healthy. Long time ago, a family lived in a city. And grandparents, along with their mummy papa, 8 years old Himanshu and 7 years old Himani were there in their family. Both the kids were very much fond of junk food. Therefore, they used to eat pizza and burger all the time and refused to eat any fruit or vegetable.
No, we don't like vegetables and fruits at all.
We like only pizza and burger.
But children, if you won't eat vegetables and fruits, then your eyesight will become poor. And you have to wear specs in such a small age.
But they never used to listen to their mother.
No, we don't like vegetables and fruits.
One day, their mother explained them very lovingly.
Our eyesight becomes strong by eating fruits and green vegetables. And if your eyesight becomes poor, then you have to wear specs all the time.
Mother's affectionate words convinced Himani to eat fruit and vegetables.
Okay, Mom. From now, I will eat fruit and vegetable every day.
But Himanshu refused to listen to his mother.
No, Mom. I like pizza burger. Therefore, I will eat that only.
Now, Mother stopped explaining Himanshu. And many days passed. Himani started eating fruit and vegetables daily. And Himanshu, like before, ate only pizza and burger. One day, Himanshu's teacher asked him in school.
Himanshu, come on, solve the question on blackboard.
When Himanshu looked at the blackboard, he found everything very blurred. He rubbed his eyes and looked once again. But still, he found everything blurred. Teacher angrily scolded Himanshu when he was unable to answer.
Himanshu, are you not able to solve this easy question also? Wait, I'll call your parents to school right now.
Teacher left the classroom after saying this. She made a phone call and after some time, Himanshu's mummy papa came to school.
I had asked Himanshu very simple question. But Himanshu could not solve as easy question as 2 plus 2.
What Himanshu? You don't even know answer of such an easy question?
It seems you aren't studying well these days.
No, Mom. I know very well. 2 plus 2 adds up to 4.
So why didn't you answer your teacher's question?
The reason was, I wasn't able to see what's written on board.
I told you before, you should eat vegetable and fruits. See, your eyesight became so weak. If like Himani you had listened to me, then your eyesight wouldn't have been so poor.
Sorry, Mom. From today, I will eat vegetables and fruits daily.
By seeing Himanshu's crying like this, his mummy understood that Himanshu has now realized his mistake. She consoled Himanshu and said,
"It's fine, Himanshu. Stop crying now. But if you eat vegetables and fruits daily, then it may be possible that your eyesight may become perfect again.
So till then, I shall buy good spectacles for you."
After listening to his mummy papa, Himanshu stopped crying and his father got his spectacles made. Like this, by eating fruit and vegetables, Himani's eyesight remained normal. And by not eating fruit and vegetables, Himanshu had to wear spectacles. Real education. Tinku and Rinki were twin siblings. They both studied in the same class, in the same school. Both were excellent in studies, but often Tinku scored better than his sister. Dad laid down a condition when both of them insisted on having a bicycle.
My budget allows me to purchase only one bicycle. So whoever will score better between you two will get the bicycle.
After hearing father's words, both the kids started studying. But Tinku was very smart. He knew how to get good marks. He used to study only that portion which was supposed to come in the exams. Whereas Rinki was fond of studies. She used to study the entire textbook.
Keep in mind, I will get the bicycle. Whatever you're studying is useless. This won't come in exams.
How do you know?
Hey, see this. Tuition sir has given me question papers of last 3 years. Every time questions are repeated from these only.
Okay, but I don't want to take any shortcut. Whatever will be the question, it will be asked from books. Let me study. Don't disturb, please.
Both the kids started studying in their own style. Finally, exams were over.
Yay! Exams are over! We will have fun!
After a few days, results were declared. And once again, same thing happened. Tinku was declared topper and Rinki stood second.
Yay! Now I will get the bicycle! Hooray!
Bicycle was gifted to Tinku. He was extremely happy.
Take this. But keep in mind that this bicycle belongs to both of you. Let Rinki also ride this.
But Tinku did not listen to anyone. He took his bicycle and ran away. That same evening, to celebrate results of both the kids, entire family went out for dinner. After finishing their dinner, when the family stepped out of the restaurant, suddenly some people approached them with mic and camera.
We are doing promotion of G1 bicycle. We have a small quiz for the kids. If you answer all the questions correctly, then you will be gifted top model of G1 bicycle, along with this new bag and a bottle too.
Both the kids participated in the quiz. Questions in the quiz were from their books only, but totally different from examination paper. Rinki had studied the book thoroughly. Hence, she solved all the questions of the quiz very quickly.
Please have this, uncle. I have solved all the questions.
That's impressive. You did it very fast. Very good.
Tinku tried very hard, but he did not know the answers and at last, he also gave the quiz paper. After looking at both the papers, organizers announced the winner.
And in this quiz, winner with 100% correct answer is Rinki!
Rinki was gifted cycle as prize along with other gifts. Whereas Tinku learned a lesson. Tinku now understood that we should not study for numbers only, but for knowledge too. Unity is strength. Long time ago, 6 years old Mishti and 7 years old Mayank lived with their mummy papa in a city. Mishti and Mayank had many toys with them, but they never shared their toys with each other. And they always used to fight on the topic that who has got more toys.
I have more toys than you.
No, I have much more toys than you. And my toys are much better than your toys.
No, I have much better toys with me than you.
One day their grandfather came to live in their house. He came with many wonderful toys.
Kids, I have brought some wonderful toys for you.
Wow! So many toys!
They both stepped forward and picked one bag each from their grandfather's hands.
These toys are mine!
And these are mine!
I have brought these toys for both of you only. So, why are you dividing these?
No, Grandpa! We never share our toys with each other!
Never ever!
Grandfather was very surprised after listening this. But he did not say anything to kids. Next day, both the kids were fighting as usual.
I have more toys than you!
No, I have much more toys than you.
This time also, grandfather thought that kids will understand with time. This went on for few days. Then one day, grandfather thought,
these kids won't learn like this. I shall teach them importance of unity.
Thinking this, he went to children's room. And in the room also, kids were fighting as usual. After looking at grandfather, they asked him,
Grandfather, come on, you tell us. Who has more toys?
Yes, Grandpa. You only tell who has more toys.
According to me, both of you don't have much toys.
What?
But you need not worry. I can double the quantity of both of your toys.
But how?
By magic.
By magic?
Yes, by magic. Now quickly close your eyes. And I shall double the quantity of both of your toys.
After hearing his words, both the children closed their eyes. Grandfather stepped forward and he mixed toys of both of them. And once again stood in front of them.
Now you can open your eyes.
Upon opening their eyes, kids found all the toys were mixed up. After seeing this, kids became very angry.
Grandpa, what have you done?
Grandfather, why did you mix our toys?
On this, grandfather made them understand by saying,
"Haven't mixed them, but I have doubled the quantity of your toys. Children, there is massive strength in unity. If we remain together always, then like these toys, our strength increases manifold. That's why we shouldn't fight among ourselves, but always should remain together."
And finally, after hearing grandfather's words, children realized the importance of living together. And after that, they never ever fought for toys.